generally common bus system is implemented in two ways. The first way is using multiplexes. The second way is using three state buffers. In the last video, we have seen how to implement a common bus system with the help of multiplexes. In this video, we are going to discuss about how to implement a common bus system with the help of three state bus buffer and decoders. This is the graphical representation of a three state buffer. We know the advantage of a buffer. Buffer is mainly useful in order to store the bits. So if the bit value is 0, then it stores 0. If the bit value is 1, it stores 1. Whereas three state buffer means it produces three states. The first state is 0, the second state is 1, whereas the third state is high impedance. High impedance means it doesn't produce any output. The output is open circuit. Open circuit means it is disconnected from the circuit. So it produces three state buffer means it produces 0, 1, high impedance. So it produces one of the three states. High impedance means it doesn't produce any output. The output is disconnected from the circuit. Now let's see the graphical representation. This is nothing but our three-state buffer symbol. It accepts a normal input as well as control input. Normal input is represented by A, control input is represented by C. Suppose if the control input is 1, then the output is, let the output is represented by 1. So what is the use of a buffer? Buffer is useful in order to store the data. So output Y is equal to A if C is equal to 1. So let here A value is 1, then what is the output? Output Y is equal to 1. Let here A value is 0, then output is Y is equal to 0 is the output. Whereas if control input is 0, then irrespective of the input, it produces high impedance. So high impedance means it doesn't produce any output. So this is about what is a three-state buffer or tri-state buffer. Okay, three-state buffer can also be known as tri-state buffer. So if control input is 1, then the output Y is equal to A. Whereas if the control input is 0, that means there is no control input, then the output is high impedance. Now let's see with the help of a bus, how we can transfer data from one register to the another register. So bus is mainly useful in order to transfer the data from one register to the another register. Here we have taken a 2x4 decoder. We know the advantage of a decoder. So on decoder we have to apply some enable input. The enable input may be either 1 or 0. So 1 means that enable input is active. So depends upon the input we will get the output. Whereas if the enable input is 0, then irrespective of input, it doesn't produce any output. So if you want to get any output, then first we have to activate the enable input. Next here we have two selection inputs. S1 and S0 are nothing but selection inputs. Here 2x4 specifies that here we have two selection inputs. And how many inputs, outputs it produces? It produces 2^2 outputs. Okay. So what are the inputs are there? There are two selection inputs are there. So if there are n inputs, then it produces 2^n outputs. So depends upon the input, one of the output will be selected. So if there are two inputs, then how many outputs it produces? It produces 4 outputs. Okay, so depends upon the input, one output will be active. So if there are two, if there are three inputs, then totally we will have 2^3 outputs. That is nothing but 8 outputs. So out of 8 outputs, one of the output will be active. That depends upon the input that we pass. Now let's take an example here. Here this is nothing but a three-state bus buffer. We know that three-state bus buffer accepts an input as well as a control input. Here for this three-state buffer, it is accepting the control input from output 0 of decoder. So here for this decoder, for the first decoder, it is getting control input from output 0 of the decoder. Next, for this decoder, it is getting input from output 1 of the decoder. Next, for this decoder, it is getting input from output 2 of the decoder. So likewise, the last decoder is getting input from output 3 of the decoder. Next, let us assume that register contains 4 bits, where the first register contains 4 bits such as A0, A1, A2, A3. Register A bits are A0, A1, A2, A3. Let size of each register is 4 bits. Likewise, let us assume that register B contains 4 bits such as B0, B1, B2, B3. Let register C contains C bits, 4 bits such as C0, C1, C2, C3. Let register D contains 4 bits such as D0, D1 and D2 and D3. But in this example, what we are doing is we are taking only the first bit from each register. So what is the first bit from the register A? From register A, A0 is the first bit. So we have taken that bit. Next, from register B, we have taken the first bit. From register C, we have taken the first bit. From register D, we have taken the first bit. So likewise, we can implement this diagram for all the bits of the register also. But the diagram will become some complex. So that's why we have taken only one bit from each register. Okay. So this decoder accepts A0 as the input. This is 3-state buffer. This 3-state buffer accepts A0 as the input. This 3-state buffer accepts B0 as the input. This 3-state buffer accepts C0 as the input. And this 3-state buffer accepts D0 as the input. Let us assume that here the enable input is 1. Let inputs are 0, 0. If 0, 0 inputs are applied, then it produces 0 as the output. So that means it produces this 0 as the output. So this line will become active now. That means this control input is active and the remaining 3 control inputs are deactive. So we know the advantage of the control input. If the control input is 1, then only it produces the output. If the control input is 0, it doesn't produce any output. Here, out of all this, if the selection inputs are 0, 0, then this decoder produces this 0 as the output. So this 0 will be passed as control input to the decoder. So now what the decoder will do? Let register A0 contains a bit called 1. So now this 3-state buffer produces this 1 as the output, and this 1 will be placed on the bus. So on the bus we are placing 1 bit. Now that bit is transferred to the destination register. Okay. The output of the bus should be connected as input to the register, so that this bit will be transferred to the register. Now let us assume that selection inputs are 0, 1. If the selection inputs are 0, 1, then it produces, the decoder produces this 1 as the output. So what will happen now? This line will become active, whereas the remaining 3 lines will become deactive. So now this 1 will be passed as input to this 3-state buffer. Now this 3-state buffer accepts, let us assume that here B0 value is 0. Now it produces, this 3-state buffer produces this 0 as the output. So this 0 information will be placed on the bus now. Now this 0 will be passed to the destination register. The output of the bus will be connected as input to the destination register. So here what we are doing, with the help of the bus, we are transferring the contents from one register to another register. So let us assume that here we want to transfer data from C to some R1. We want to transfer data from C register to R1 register. So for that, what we have to do? We have to apply the selection lines 1, 0. So whenever we apply the selections 1, 0, then what will happen? This 2 will become active. It will produce as 2 as the output. So now if this 2 will become active, whereas the remaining 3 will become inactive. So this will be applied as control input to the 3-state buffer. So now what will happen? Let us assume that here C0 bit is 1. So this 3-state buffer produces 1 as the output. So this 1 will be placed on the bus. So this is nothing but bus. So bus stores some information. Now, so what is happening? Here, C information is placed on the bus. Now the output of the bus will be connected to the input of the R1. So this 1 will be transferred to the R1. So in this way, we can implement common bus system with the help of 3-state buffer or tri-state buffer.